Dear teachers, welcome to Diploma in Elementary Education program of NIOS. Hope you all are doing well. I am Madhusudan JV from University of Hyderabad, course coordinator of 507, that is Community and Elementary Education. Policymakers, educators, and others involved in education have very well recognized the significant role communities can play in the administration, management, and monitoring of the educational institutions. There is also a mounting evidence that community involvement in school can have a dramatic impact on education access, retention, and even quality. One of the important recommendations of the National Policy on Education 1986 was related to empowering communities for the management of educational institutions at the local level. The National Policy on Education very well recommended the establishment of an appropriate institutional framework at the district and sub-district level, such as District Board of Education and Village Education Committee, in order to ensure that community members play an important role in the management of primary education. The move towards decentralization and empowerment of community got a further fillip with the 73rd and 74th constitutional amendment relating to Panchayati Raj institutions. Against this backdrop, you will be dealing with the course 507, that is Community and Elementary Education. Let us have the overview of the course. This course, as you know, has three blocks, that is block number 1 pertaining to society, community and school, block 2 pertains to school system, and block 3 deals with managing school community interface. For instance, block 1 as usual has 4 units, that is unit number 1 deals with society and education, wherein you study the introductory parts and the connection between society and education. Similarly, in unit number 2, you will study the linkage between community and school in a more detailed manner. Further, in unit number 3, you will see the contribution of community in school education. Similarly, unit number 4 deals with provisions for community participation under Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan and also under Right to Education Act. Then, when we look at block number 2, we have again 4 units. Unit number 5 deals with entitlements of the child and school provisions. Unit number 6 deals with, in detailed fashion, teacher and the school, the role of teacher in relation to the community participation. Then unit number 7 again deals with teacher leadership. And unit number 8 deals with relationship with education agencies. Similarly, block 3 takes care of again 4 units, that is unit number 9. Here, the important part is it is based on practical aspects, community mobilization, as it is a practical based one. Then unit number 10 deals with management of school. Then in unit number 11, you will deal with resource management of school and community. And similarly, unit number 12 deals with management approaches of school and community partnerships. If you look at more detail unit wise, for example, unit number 1, wherein the in terms of learning objectives, you will try to understand and define society and discuss its constituent institutions, their relationships and functions. And also you will be able to describe the nature of Indian society, its evolution and relationship with education system. And also you will be able to analyze the linkage between society and education. Further, you will be able to discuss the role of schools as an organ of the society. And coming to unit number 2, you will be able to describe the concept of community as a miniature society, and you will be able to analyze the role of community in the context of elementary education. You will be able to explain the linkages between community and school, and also you will be able to discuss the influence of community on the language development of the learner. Also, you will be able to illustrate the influence of community on the cultural development of the learner, and you will be able to relate the influence of community on the life skills development of the learner. Further, when we go to unit number 3, you will be able to understand why and how the community could be involved in school education, and you will be able to analyze the importance of the involvement of community in school education. And also you will be able to discuss the various methods used by community to get involved in school education. Further, to discuss the field level experiences from which the teachers and head teachers could learn and understand the need for involving the community in school education. This unit as a whole, especially the third unit, would explain to you the concept of community and its contribution in the improvement of school education. In similar fashion, you will learn interesting aspects pertaining to interaction of elementary education and community in remaining two blocks spread over 12 units. I look forward for your active participation. For further information, you may contact me. I wish you all the best. Thank you.